courting the grey vote.
Please tell me what the unemployment rate is in Australia.
4%.
I'm going to vote.
Thank you.
Campaigns descending on the nation's senior citizens.
Hi, how are you?
Both leaders engaging on one of the most expensive policy areas in the nation. Aged care also central during last night's debate.
Putting the nurses back into nursing homes.
We can't just make nurses all of a sudden fall out of the sky.
But it was regional security that really stepped up the tension in the room.
This isn't so much a Pacific step up, it's a Pacific stuff up.
Why would you take China's side?
That's an outrageous slur.
The Prime Minister's accused Labor of siding with China before, today defending his rhetoric.
Why did you repeat that comment when our national security agencies are saying it is not helpful?
Well, see, when you're Prime Minister, you're running the government. Public servants don't run the government. We set a very high bar when it comes to national security. And if the Labor Party wants to aspire to that, then I think they have to lift their game.
This government have gone missing. They had enough notice to engage and do something about this.
Beijing's next move in the Pacific to be closely monitored.
You can expect the Chinese to do all they can now that they've got this agreement signed.
Not the only debate drama left unresolved.
I have a 4-year-old autistic son. We are grateful to receive funds through the NDIS, but I've heard many stories of people having their funds cut recently.
Jenny and I have been blessed. We've got two children that haven't had to go through that.
Drawing criticism from the highest ranks in Labor.
Well, as the parent of a wonderful daughter with autism, I was really upset by that comment. I found it really offending and quite shocking.
But a muted response from the leader.
I think every child is a blessing for parents.
It's really disappointing to hear us portrayed in those same tired old stereotypes where we're either inspirational or we're a pitiful burden of welfare and charity.
Wheelchair tennis champion and Australian of the Year Dylan Alcott also making his views known. Woke up this morning feeling very blessed to be disabled. I reckon my parents are pretty happy about it too.
And I deeply apologise for any offence that it caused.
Enjoying the Sunshine State for the first time in this campaign. Last night's debate was a reminder of how tight the competition will be. Scott Morrison is aiming to hold on to the coalition's most marginal seat in Longman.
As the campaign diversions continue, Pablo Viñales, SBS World News.